Hello, buddy. Isaiah Velez here, the host of The New Me. Thank you for subscribing to this YouTube channel. Thank you for watching these videos, guys. You have really blessed me. You have really been an encouragement in my life. I thank you so much. And like I always say, like this video, share it, and subscribe if you haven't already. So, thank you so much. My goal here is to really encourage you in the Lord, build your faith, and light you blaze, fire of the Holy Ghost, and show you the love of God, His true love, and really bless you on Monday and Wednesday. So like I always say, like it, share it, and subscribe, and watch this, and be blessed.
Today, I pray you are having a blessed day so far. If you're not having a blessed day, this is going to bless you. Amen. Glory to God. I want to talk to you today about God fights your battles. God fights your battles. And it's true. It's very true. So, before I get into it, let's read Psalms 91 together. Receive this for you, receive this for your family, and to close over your life. Amen. Hallelujah. So it says, whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High, rests in the shadow of the Mighty, and say of the Lord, He is my refuge, my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fire of snare, from the dead pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and His wings you will find refuge. His faith must be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor pestilence sucks at dawn, nor plague towards the midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You only preserve your eyes, the impression of the wicked. See, the Lord is my refuge, make the Most High a dwelling. No harm will overtake you, so as to come to your tent. For He will command His angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands, so you do not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread upon a lion, the cobra. You will tread upon the lion, the serpent. Because He loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue Him, I will protect Him, for He nods my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer Him. I will be with Him in trouble. I will deliver Him and honor Him, and prolong life by satisfy Him, and show Him my salvation. Psalms 91. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God. Glory to His name. Hallelujah. So go with me to Psalms 18. So this, man, this scripture is powerful. I love the scripture. Okay, so it says, I love you, Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God is my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I call to the Lord, who is worthy of praise, and I have been saved from my enemies. The cold soap, man, I picture this as me, because this was me. This really was me. So the cords of death entangled me, the torrents of destruction overwhelmed me. The cold, the grave cold around me, the snares of death confronted me. My disaster, I called to the Lord, I cried to my God for help. From His temple, He heard my voice, my cry came before His. My cry came before Him into His ears. The earth trembled and quaked, and the foundations of the mountains shook. They trembled because He was angry. Now this man is powerful. Smoke rose from His nostrils. Now I want to say this. Don't ever say that God doesn't love you, doesn't care about you, because this is love right here. Smoke rose from His nostrils. Consuming fire came from His mouth. burning coals blazed out of it. It parted the heavens and came down. Dark clouds were under his feet. He mounted the cherub and flew. He soared on the wings of the wind. He made darkness his covering, his canopy around him, the dark rain clouds of the sky. Out of the brightness of his presence, clouds advanced with hailstones and bolts of lightning. The Lord thundered from heaven, the voice of the Most High resounded. He shot his arrows and scattered the enemy with great bolts of lightning. He routed them. The valleys of the sea were exposed, and the foundations of the earth laid bare. At your rebuke, Lord, with the blast of breath from your nostrils, he reached down from on high and took hold of me. He drew me out of deep waters. He rescued me from my powerful enemy, from my foes who were too strong for me. They confronted me in the day of my disaster, but the Lord was my support. Man, I can just end this right now and just be done, because that was powerful. And Tony, I want to say this. I'm not going to be on here long. I know I always say that, but I'm going to try not to. I think of this movie in Narnia. And when the battle seems lost, Aslan, he comes in with that powerful roar of the lion. And I think of that as God coming in, our defender, our strengthener. One when people said, you know, he's not real, he's not this, not that. Better be careful, I'm telling you right now. Better be careful, because that day is coming when you will stand before God and you will give an account for every single thing that you did on this earth. So either you repent now, or it's over, baby. It's over, and people might say, oh, you know what? I'll repent when I talk to God face to face. It's over. I don't know what book you're reading. But this pastor said the book of imaginations. Probably reading that, because it doesn't say that in the Bible. It doesn't say, you know what? Repent when you see me face to face. No, that's over. It's either heaven or hell. It's either you're gonna and there's no middle ground. I've heard this from people. You know, I'm just gonna be in the middle. Okay, there is no middle. There's either heaven or hell. You're not gonna be on the gates. You're not gonna be on the side gate. Hey, you know what? God is just gonna put you on this. You're special. You're just beyond this gate. No. Do you understand that hell was not made for you? It was made for the devil and his angels, his fallen angels. It wasn't made for you. People say, why does God send people to hell? God does not send people to hell. Your own sin sends you to hell. What we do, either death or life, determines what happens. If we don't accept Jesus, we're done. We're done. Hell is not full, heaven is not full of good people. They are full of people that said yes to Jesus. And hell is not full of bad people. People get that mixed up. Hell is full of people that said no to Jesus and served other gods, served other idols. Heaven is full of people who said yes to Jesus. I choose you, Jesus. Nobody else but you. That's who it's full of. So choose wisely. I'm telling you right now. Who you serve. These false idols. You better be careful. You need to be careful with that. These false religions. They didn't die for you. the statues. They did not die for you. You have to offer them sacrifices. You have to give them something. But Jesus already gave you life more abundantly, free. Freely. Freely, he did it. What do I have to do, Isaiah? All you have to do is say a prayer. Simple as that. People make it complicated. It's not complicated. It's just saying a prayer. And getting saved and born again. Then, you start your journey with God. Get on track. You follow him. You follow him. And I don't want you to go to hell. I don't judge you. I'm not mad at you. I love you. I care about you. That's why I'm on here. And I pray for those people that are homosexuals, that are in that LGBTQ, whatever letters they put in now, stuff. I pray for them. I don't curse at them. I don't talk bad about them. I want them to be saved. They're just lost. Like I was. I was lost. That's them. They're lost in their identity. They don't know who they are. That could be you watching right now. You're lost in your identity. You don't know who you are. You're hearing so many people say this and this and this and this. Who God says you are. You are a child of the Most High God, an overcomer, a victor, a victorious man and woman of God. You are a victor. A victor. You are a child of God. Do you realize the royalty you carry on the inside of you? You are so beautiful. You are so worthy. People might say, what? I'm this, I'm that, I'm loved. I'm worthy. I'm cared for. Yes. I haven't heard that before. Because people always want to put you down. People always want to say these things. That's not true. Don't listen to that. Let God tell you who you are. Let God go in that prayer closet and let God speak to you. Let him minister to you and let him speak out who you are. Man. That's just, what was I? Okay. I don't know who that was for, but that was for somebody. I just wanted to say that. But that's like God coming in. And I think of that one. Because the lion, Aslan, you know, he jumps. And that's just like at the end, he jumps on the witch and he kills her. And that's like the devil. When he tries to kill you, he jumps. God jumps over you. He says, not my child. Get your hands off my child. Don't you touch my child. The love of my life. Don't you dare touch him. That's what he does. He takes you from the deep waters, dusts you off, and he says, follow me, my child, follow me. I don't know what you've been through this day. I don't know what you've gone through. I do not know. I've heard stories. I've heard people what they've gone through, and it breaks my heart to pieces. Antonio, it breaks my heart to pieces. It's only God that I hold it together, because inside, it breaks my heart. Inside, I'm crying. I'm just heartbroken on what they're going through. That's why I hug people. That's why I hold them. because I want to show the love of God to you. That's all it's going to be. The love and the fire of the Holy Ghost that's inside of you. That's what's going to show forth. That's what's going to be. So I don't know what you've gone through. I don't know what you've been through. But can I just tell you that you are loved and you matter to God. You are valued by Him. You are the treasure. You are the best. You are treasured by God. You are royalty to Him. I don't have notes, I don't have nothing. I'm just speaking, my Holy Spirit's speaking through me. This way is telling you, you are royalty. You are a child of God. Forget the past. It's a new day. So choose Him. Say this prayer after me. Come on. Say this after me. Let go of everything that's held you back. Let go of those friends. If they don't want to follow you, or you're going with God, hey, you know what? Let them go. They won't want your friends to begin with anyway. There's always an end to a friend. God will bring you right, righteous people to bring alongside you. So let those people go. If they don't want to follow you, let them go. Let them go. We don't have time for that. Choose Him. Say His prayer after me. And you'll be saved, born again. Say, Dear Lord Jesus, come into my heart and forgive me my sin. Wash me, cleanse me, set me free, Lord. Jesus, thank you that you died for me. I believe that you have risen from the dead. And you come back in for me. Fill with the Holy Spirit. Gain passion for the And gain passion for the lost. And you hunger for things of God. And a holy boldness to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm saved and born again. I'm forgiven. I'm on my way to heaven because I have Jesus in my heart. Amen, amen, amen. And pray with you, Father God. Thank you so much now by your blood and by your spirit, Lord. That on that day, Lord, they stand before you, not one, Lord, of a missing wisdom, powerful way to pack generation. But give a demonic attack of attack from hell against them right now. Speak the blood of Jesus over them. We choose you. They choose you this day. They choose you. And they will follow you to the end. And you fight our battles, God. You fight our battles. We do not need to fight. We do not need to be distracted. We do not need to fight these things. You are a defender. You protect us. You are a protector. You shield us from the enemy. We thank you for it now. In Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. Man, something just came to me. Amber, the Narnia movie, when he makes the deal and everything. Because she wants the son of Adam. But then Aslan comes out and he says he has renounced the claim on the son of Adam's blood. And she wanted Edmund, but he made a deal. And she says, how do I know your promise will be kept? And man, that war, that lion war, is powerful. When he does that, I'm telling you, it's like, it's like silence. That's like the devil. When he tries to come at God, he's like, how do I know? How are you the son of God? Shh. Shut up. Shut up, devil. You're under our feet. You've lost already. You lost 2,000 years ago. You are a defeated foe. You can never get back your place. So you've lost. You've lost. People say, but look what's going on in the world, Isaiah. I know what's going on in the world. I see the same things you do. I know. I'm not blind. I see. I can see. Thank you, Jesus. I can see. But I'm not in fear. I'm not in worry. I pray. I read my word. I'm not in fear. I eat what God tells me and my family to eat. And we pray. So I don't have fear because of all everything that's going on in the world now. I don't know. God's got this. So guys, I love you. God loves you. God bless you. And share this with somebody. Like it, share, comment, do whatever you have to do to get the word out. Share this with somebody. Be a blessing. Only be a blessing to God's people. Okay? So guys, I love you guys so much, and I want to thank you guys so much for watching this. I mean, you've really been a blessing. I love this. I've been doing this for 2 years, and this has been a blessing. I'm excited. I'm truly excited what God's gonna do in 2024. I'm telling you, and in these next few months as well, before 2023 ends, I'm excited. These next few months, what God's going to do, I'm telling you, He's going to bring in the people. The people are going to pour in, and the views, and people will be touched by God. They won't see me, but they will just see Jesus. They will just see Jesus, the love of Jesus. They will just see Him. That's all I want them to see. I don't want you guys to see me. I just want you to see Jesus. Hallelujah. So guys, I love you. God loves you. God bless you. And live this day in spiritual victory. God's got you. You are victorious. Keep going. Don't stop. And I will see you guys next week for Decree and Declare. God bless you.